This video is about how to carry out metasynthesis of qualitative studies. When you have multiple qualitative studies on the same topic, it would be nice to integrate, analyze, and interpret the findings of qualitative study in order to make out new meanings out of the study. That is why we conduct metasynthesis. Metasynthesis helps to understand the summative or aggregate knowledge of the qualitative study. It also helps to understand the common themes and patterns of the qualitative studies which one has analyzed. It helps to gain deeper insights because we are studying the whole lot of qualitative studies. Gives us deep interpretation than a single qualitative study. Also, it enables holistic understanding of the topic. In other words, it helps to look at a phenomena from a complete sense by analyzing these qualitative studies. Also, such studies can be a guide points to understand the inconsistencies and controversies of the subject which we are investigating. This could be one of the means of filling a research gap which individual studies could not do. As with any systematic literature review, metasynthesis of qualitative studies also has a guideline to be followed. One of the most famous guideline is PRISMA, which is an acronym for Preferred Reporting Items for Systematic Reviews. The PRISMA guidelines helps us to develop and enhance transparency in the findings. However, we should note that PRISMA guidelines cannot be used as it is for a metasynthesis. This is because it is widely designed for systematic reviews and meta-analysis. We need to adapt the principles of PRISMA guidelines for metasynthesis in order to bring out transparency and reliability of the findings. We offer here the generic protocol for conducting metasynthesis. It starts with title. Try to provide a clear title for the review. In the abstract, it's good to provide a summary of what are the objectives of the study, the data sources, study eligibility or inclusion and exclusion criteria, synthesis, how it is done, whether you are using a particular methodology, followed by results and conclusion. It is a good practice in the introduction to provide the rationale for why the metasynthesis of qualitative data is carried out. We need to state explicitly the objectives, followed by the eligibility criteria for including and excluding the studies. In terms of the methods used, it is good first you start with the information sources. Describe the information sources in terms of databases, Scopus, Web of Science, PubMed, Google Scholar, or any other database which you are using for the study. After this, an explicit description of search database in terms of search criteria has to be stated. What is the search string? How are the search string designed? One of the guidelines is look at design the search string based on the population which your study is looking at in terms of exposure to the phenomena the study is contemplating and the outcomes. In terms of study selection, try to be clear in terms of how the inclusion and exclusion criteria is looked at. Data collection process may be elucidated so that there is transparency. Take for instance, you are searching with a particular key term. You find n number of hits. It is good to include those so that we get a transparent view of the process by which you have carried out the literature review. In order to avoid the biases in the study, it is good to provide a reflexive note. The reflexive note will help the readers to understand the preposition of the researcher towards the study. Why is this important? Because readers can understand what was the presuppositions which the researcher brought into while carrying out the study. After you have accumulated all the literature which you are going to use for your study, it is good practice to judge the quality of the literatures or papers you are using for the study. There are many methods of judging quality of a qualitative research paper. One of the most popular ones are the study by Walsh and Down et al. have proposed a methodology to categorize the qualitative studies based on certain predetermined criteria which the researcher can use in advance. Take for instance, the researcher wants to judge a qualitative study based on how a thematic analysis was carried out. Was there any association of themes with qualitative data in terms of verbatim? Or in other words, was real life quotes of participants used to depict the qualitative themes and its association so that evidence could be judged by the reader? Similarly, many criteria a researcher can quantify and judge it based on maybe the criteria proposed by Down and Walsh, who talks about giving 4 rating to a study which has no flaws and rating 1 to a study which has flaws. Usually, in a metasynthesis, we consider study with rating 2 and above. Once the quality of the articles are selected, and you select articles which according to your study has a good quality score, we come to data extraction and analysis. Here is where we follow the process of thematic analysis. It starts with reading the papers very closely, trying to find the themes which the authors have stated, trying to form a structure, A, B, C, D themes, and then analyzing other papers, collecting the themes together, try to look at similarity and dissimilarity so that the thematic list and the relationship between the themes could be identified. Once the themes are identified, it is a good practice to understand the level of confidence you have on each themes. For that, there are various tools. One of the most widely used tool is GRADE, CERQAR. It is developed by Levin and it is widely used. It helps to judge the methodological limitations and adequacy of data while conducting a thematic analysis. You score the themes which you have unearthed based on high to low. So this, in other words, helps the researcher to understand what is the level of confidence of the themes which was unearthed in the study. After you have all the findings and synthesis of all the themes for a particular topic, it's good to summarize the evidence. Look at in terms of what is the contribution this synthesis or metasynthesis had towards the problem which you are investigating in a holistic sense. Look at the limitations of the study and then conclude the literature review.